How old are you now, Monkey?
29.
This makes mommy 48. So yeah, we've been together for a very long time. And Leslie and I both have been, I guess, a journey of growing up together, because we kind of grew up together, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
And how was that? How was that for you? Like, how did you...
It was great. I had an amazing childhood. I went to protest march. I traveled, so I never wanted for anything. And all this in a single parent household, so...
Leslie thinks that because I was a single parent that she didn't miss out on anything in life. And I believe that that was wrong. I believe that she missed out on a lot because she didn't have two viable parents to make her life better. You go down a different road when you don't have two parents, I believe. You have a different journey.
I don't think that's the case every time. I think if the parent that you are living with is still, you know, culturing their child, doing everything they can with their child, and motivated by their child, I don't think it makes that much of a difference. It's probably harder on that parent, I agree to that, but I wouldn't trade in my childhood for anything.
I could have made her world a lot better if she'd had a steady father figure. I think by the time I got married, you were probably like 10 or somewhere around there. At least 10 when I got married, and that situation upended. But I think she missed out on a great deal when she didn't have a mother and a father in her life. And I think it molded her life in a different way. And I think as single women, we think that it's okay to not to have a household that does not have the man involved. I think it's wrong. I think you should have two viable parents. And I think as that child goes out in life, they have a better opportunities, better mindset, availability to other people, to understand love. I think I cheated my daughter somewhat out of something. I really do. I never told you that, Leslie, but I really think I cheated you.
I don't feel that way at
all. I don't know how she doesn't feel that way.
Mm-mm. No, I was very happy as a child. So I'm not saying, you know, I didn't want a second parent there, but I never felt empty or missing something. But I know that's not the case all the time with other people, and that's fine. I mean, I'm not saying, oh, single parent, everybody should do it. I'm just saying the experience doesn't have to be a bad one. It can be great, and mine was.
She believes that to this day. I still think I was a half-ass parent. I really believe that. Mm-hmm. And the child still turned out to be a great child, military-wise. She's in service, and she's a college graduate, so I obviously did somewhat of a great job. Not a great job, but I mean, I didn't do the most fantastic job. I think I could have did a better job if I had a understanding of life. Because when you're a child and you have a child, there's no way you can understand what to do and how to do this. You're going to get so much shit wrong, it's unbelievable. So, I still think I cheated her. And Mother's Day is right around the corner, and I mean, now that we both understand about life, I think we both have a better understanding. I think she does.
I mean, I'm still learning a lot,
What do you think you're learning more now?
I'm not that prepared. I haven't bought my first home yet.
She stays
still
that.
Getting, you know, trying to handle my money properly, so I think I still have a lot to learn.
When I had Leslie, you got to think, I was motivated by her. So when she came into my life, I started just pushing. I mean, I had this one kid, and me and her, I'm just going to show her that I can do anything to make her life easier. And I did that. I really pushed her, and I really pushed myself to live the best life. And I believe that me and her together were a dynamic duo. I believe that. I did a lot with her. I cultured her. I showed her a lot of the world. So she was very privileged to see a lot of the world and do a lot of different things with her mom. So, but again, I don't advocate being a single parent. I really don't. I think that you should have two people in the household making the decisions for the children. The children will learn more from having that. Because I think now it's just, you miss out on so much, Leslie. You do. Because, yeah, I mean, your dad, your relationship with your dad was, you know, it's better now.
Yeah, for some reason, I never even craved that typical daddy-daughter relationship. I mean, it was just, hey, I got my mom. That's where I'm at. And that's probably not a mentality somebody should have, but I'm just saying that's the mentality I had. And I didn't feel sorry for myself because he wasn't around like that. It never crossed my mind that way.
I always thought it was weird that he, you know, that we, now me and her are together, and I have to try and figure out how to make her understand that a lot of things that she's going through now is because of the lack thereof of her father, I believe. You don't think that emotionally you're like a little more standoffish towards people and stuff?
Probably, but I think that's just because I'm an Aquarius and we tend to be
she's going to say
loners.
That's a sign of her emotion.
I don't know. My daddy's also standoffish. He doesn't like to go around
true.
A lot of people.
That's
He's not
true.
Very people person.
He's not.
He's not. He's just, you know, he's military too, so it's just
big military background in her life. So it was inevitable that she goes into the military. I always knew that. So I guess we're just talking about things that black women don't ever talk to their children, or we as black women have never, you know, Mother's Day is right around the corner, and we always say, oh, we're just great mothers, and we're single mothers, and we do all this powerful shit, and sometimes we just suck. Honestly, we really do suck. We really don't know how to be a parent when you're, like, young and you have a child. You don't know shit, and the world is, like, telling you, oh, you can do this. This is not a problem. They're lying to you. You're going to have a whole lot of problems. A child's going to have a whole lot of problems.
Yeah, but you didn't suck as a parent. I don't.
Girl, I sucked.
I didn't think so.
Oh, man. See how she's blind.
I don't think y'all give yourselves enough credit. Like, nobody's, you know, glorifying being a single parent. But at the same time, you can still, you don't have to make the experience so horrible or, oh, the child is going to be ruined forever. Because that's not always the case.
Just because the lights never got shut off, and because you never went hungry, and because you always had a home and you were stable, does not make a parent a great or a good parent. It just makes us, that's what we should have done anyway. All I'm saying is that we should have done it with two parties in the household. That's all I'm saying.
Right, and I can understand that.
Please do. Please do. That's all, you know, again, Mother's Day is around the corner and they're going to give us all these praises and we're going to say, oh, we're good mothers and fathers. And I'm going to tell you that you're not. You're either, we're okay parents, and it's okay to be an okay parent. You know?
Oh, you're a great mother, so.
Oh, she's going to say. She's going to say. All right. Well, that's the end of this video. We just thought we'd do a little test shot video of how we're going to live our best life. Right?
Yep.
All right. You can stop it. All right. We're going to have to edit this thing.